Hi, I'm Melanie Dyer. You're watching Live on the Lot on Skippy TV, and today I'm here with one of Australian country music's most gorgeous voices, in my opinion, and an incredible singer-songwriter, Felicity Urquhart.
Hello.
Welcome back. You've been here before with Bennett Botel Urquhart Trio.
Yes.
Do you feel a little lonely?
Yeah, a little lonely.
Soldier today.
Well, it's so nice. So no, I miss my friends, but
we don't need you guys.
No, that's not my take. 10 years though since my last solo outing. So this is like, I don't know. So much has changed in 10 years from the online presence, social media, all of that. Yeah. I've got to get up to speed with how it's sort of done now. And when I share it with my mates, Lynn kind of was across all of that. So she took the reins there. So now I'm really having to, step up.
Yeah, exactly. Well, you've been wearing a lot of different hats in the last 10 years. I mean, so much has happened from marriage, kids. I'll let you get into it all. But what's sort of happened in the last 10 years since your last record?
You just named it all, actually. This weekend, too, is our wedding anniversary, then our children.
Yes. Is that what you say, congratulations on being married?
We're still married. Yes, I think so in this day and age.
I know. That's quite an achievement.
I'm spruiking that. and we've got our two daughters. Busy juggling that with work, radio work, television work, and also still dabbling with helping young kids coming through the New South Wales school system through the Talent Development Project when I can.
Exactly.
So I just love, I don't know, being present. Whatever you're doing, just staying, out and about and having a go at it.
Yeah. Well, you've definitely got your finger in all the pies, so they say. Let's talk about the Talent Development Project. I didn't even think to mention that, but you're a past graduate yourself, and I've been through it as well, and that's something you do a lot of is help the younger generation come up and learn their craft. So what are you sort of doing there at TDP now?
It's so wonderful. And Mel, I mean, I was way back in the second year that 93, I think I was participating.
Wow.
And a graduate. And there's been some incredible names over the years from Human Nature, Paulini. In the country scene, we've had Darren Coggan, yourself,
McClymonts,
so many of us, Travis, Kirsty Lee Acres, another one through the doors. So there's loads of country kids, loads of kids from jazz to pop. And what I love about coming back and helping with workshops now is it fills my bucket up too. I really get a buzz out of seeing young artists that are just loving and wanting to soak up information about music and writing songs and their starry-eyed ideas about, being international superstars. And you never want to take that away from anybody.
No, you want to encourage it.
I know what that was like. I had those exact same stars when I started out. So we're not trying to build fake dreams, but we're trying to give them tools in their bag of tricks. So it's lovely to be part of it.
Exactly. And you've got such a nurturing personality yourself, and you're a mother of two beautiful girls who I think might be a little musical. They make a little cameo in your current single, which is Chain of Joy, that you performed for us before. Tell us about the clip. It's very cute.
Well, look, we got the kids out in the backyard, put up some fairy lights, and Glenn was kind enough to get behind the camera and help. And then the kids were like one take through and thought, that was great. Can we go and have an icy pole now? No, we need to do it a few more times. Yeah. So we did spoil them with treats. We bribed them
to do it.
Yes, we did. But the kids love music. We've got our seven-year-old playing violin, and Ellie's sort of playing ukulele and singing, and they've been busking at Tamworth for the last 4 years. So
that's awesome. And that's where you first started. You grew up in Tamworth, so it must be pretty cool to see your girls on the streets of Peel Street, making some music.
It's lovely. I am so busy during the festival, it's really hard to get down to see the kids.
Yeah.
So I do, though, and so does Glenn, but my sister helps out.
I was going to say, do you just leave them there?
No.
Bye, kids, have fun.
Yeah, we'll see you when you've got a guitar case full of money.
Exactly.
No, my sister's kind enough. She takes them out because my nephews also are in their little band. land. They're called the Meadows. Aww. And so there's the four of them. And then my mum and dad, so Nan and Pop are out there watching the kids and Aww. Carrying the gear. And,
I love and that.
I tell you what, it's hard yakka when the temperatures are like they
oh
were this
gosh.
Year.
Yes, it's like stifling heat. You just put on a face of makeup and just sweat it straight off.
That's one thing the kids don't have to worry about.
Exactly.
We just put these cool cooling little things that they wear around their necks.
Oh, the little towel things?
Yeah, and yes, that's it. Some cooling
stuff.
But then you wave it and it gets icy cold and they just keep singing and playing. So they love it.
Yes. Oh, that'll keep them entertained while you're busy running around during
that's
the
right.
festival.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Glenn. So your husband, you mentioned
yes.
him before and he was playing as well, guitar. He's a multi-talented
yeah.
man himself. You guys just must have a crazy musical household.
It's either producing other people's albums Glenn works on, or session work, or photography, or design. So he's multi-skilled,
mm-hmm.
and it's lovely that when it comes to working on projects that I'm involved with, that we are the little cottage house that sort of does it all, and it's great. He knows me better than anybody because he has to live with me.
Exactly. So, and your studio's at the house as well.
Yes,
it's handy. How do you switch off and sort of...
I think, I grew up with my dad being an upholsterer and his workshop was at our house residence. So mm-hmm. I grew up knowing that there's the house part and the workspace.
Yeah.
And
you've got to separate.
Yeah.
That.
And my dad did that well, clocked on for work time, clocked off for family time.
Mm-hmm.
And so as soon as we walk into the studio, it's that world. And if it's songwriting world, we both know how to flick those switches quite easily. And it's always encompassing the kids at every stop. So
yeah.
they're very much involved with it, but they also know how to be quiet when mum and dad are working.
Well, that's good. You've got the well-trained there.
Yeah.
It would be easy to clock off when the kids are probably yelling, Mum, lunchtime, or Mum, I've got my homework.
Oh, yeah, well, that's right. Well, we do make sure that we have allocated time for everything. Yeah.
For sure. Well, let's talk about the new album. That's why you're here.
Yeah.
It's coming out very soon. Called Frozen Rabbit.
Yes.
Please explain to me what does that mean?
what have I got in my freezer?
yeah.
There is not a single rabbit in
it's
my freezer.
It's not Peter Rabbit.
No. It's
and at Easter time. You're releasing
yes.
around Easter time. That's perfect.
Didn't even think about that connection. Nice point
pick
out
up.
There. Yeah, nice pick up. It's a song off the album,
mm-hmm.
and it was the first track we started to record. So sonically, it set the tone
mm-hmm.
where we were headed. And I wrote this song with Mark Seymour, and I've been collaborating with Mark over a number of years.
Awesome.
Great writer,
yeah.
and just one of those legendary Australian artists that no matter what Mark does, it's quality and substance. And
yeah, throw your arms around me.
Oh,
that was
yes.
Oh,
incredible.
Yeah.
So it was really lovely to know that this was where it all began. It was like the heartbeat of the album, I suppose.
Mm.
And I thought it just seemed right to be the title track. And I'm loving this industry. I've always loved where I sit.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to be frozen in country music.
Okay.
So there's that element too. But the song is about lyrically, you know, chasing the clock or watching the clock and occasionally running for your life. And so that element is very true for me.
I get that. And do you have sort of a favourite song, something that resonates most, or is it something that's very special?
At all different times. Songs, there's a couple of songs that do talk about the time factor and slow it down. Another one that we played today, and that is referencing to that too. And that was from my friend Carl Brody.
Yeah.
And Carl actually joins me on the album. We recorded that together before Carl found out he was sick. So it's lovely to have that moment as well captured.
Oh, for sure. So, yeah, that's very special.
Yeah. And so that one's particularly close to my heart. And then other elements in there talking about family songs, songs about friends, and it depends
life.
What mode I'm in at the time, I suppose.
Yeah, well, that makes sense. It'd be hard to kind of pick your favourite. It's like picking a favourite
child. Some days I can do that quite easily.
We won't tell the girls that.
They probably know that, though.
Yeah, they sense things. Kids are very smart.
They surely do.
It's all in the tone.
Did I just get extra flushed? I think so.
Let's talk about touring. So I'm assuming you're going to be doing a bunch of shows with the new album.
Yes.
In the past, you have opened for some pretty incredible artists.
Yeah.
Willie Nelson, Kenny Rogers, Sheryl Crow.
Yeah, that's an amazing mixed bag, isn't it?
Yeah, that's amazing that you're an artist that can fit with all of those types of...
Well, in the shows. You know, when you mention Willie Nelson, there's somebody that has been a huge inspiration. It doesn't matter what Willie touches, he just makes it work, you know. Mm. It can be sort of from the jazz classics to hardcore country.
Yeah.
And I just think that's the essence of a great artist, is just trying to, or just be real in whatever you're sinking your teeth into. And at the core, it's always Willie's sound. So I think that's, you know, I'd like to take a page out of Willie's book.
Yeah, that's where you fit as well. I think that you do the same kind of thing there with your music, you know.
Well, you know, that's, as long as I can be truthful in whatever I'm doing, and having me staying true at the core of it is really important. So, you know, working with Willie and having him come and say good day, and Waylon Jennings watching side stage.
This is amazing.
It was incredible. And I will never forget that. Yeah. And Kenny Rogers, another one, all these incredible, iconic artists that you just know, they're just like us, they're just people, and they just happen to have these other gifts that, you know, set their careers up for a lifetime.
Quite nicely. Yeah. And another one, actually, just recently, you got up and performed with Jim Lauderdale.
Oh, I love
CMC
Jim.
CMC Rocks and his little intimate show at Low 302 here in Sydney. And yeah, you actually recorded one of his songs, didn't you?
Yeah, Planet of Love, and that was from an album called Swingtown. Mm-hmm. And so that was probably more of the swing, early swing influenced country, right? And so I really sunk my teeth into that, and there was this fabulous Jim tune, Planet of Love, that just fit my project, and I got had the pleasure of working with Jim over in the States as well, and so we've known each other for a long time now, and it was about time he came back to us.
Yes,
to Australia.
And so he should get you up and sings, and you did.
So lovely,
pretty cool,
so lovely.
Yeah, well, I feel like your voices sort of do a similar thing to an audience when you're listening to you guys perform. Like, it's a captivating, really vocally driven performance that I am so into, and a lot of other people obviously are. So I'm really excited to hear the new album. I'm sure you've got lots of beautiful vocal moments on there.
Well, it's interesting. This time I wasn't too emotional. Normally I have a bit of a cry and I have a bit of this, you know, whatever going on. But this time I'd really just, I don't know, I just, with getting a bit older and all these other things going on, I suppose, I just knew the essence of each, where I wanted it to be and the message I wanted to get across.
Yeah, well, I guess you're more sure of yourself now, and having been about 10 years since your last album, you've got all your ducks in a row now.
Well, you know, occasionally a few
and rabbits.
Ducks, yeah.
The rabbits in a row. Does that work?
I like that. Yeah. Going with that.
And what about Brad Butcher? You've recently teamed up with him as well.
Thank you. I'm so glad you said that. I'm touring with Brad. It's our New Harmony tour.
Yep.
And we've taken New Harmony as one of my tracks off the album and gone with that. It's the next single. And he's just so talented and lovely guy. He's got a new album coming out as well this year. We played together at Tamworth and I hit him up on stage, actually asked him if he'd come touring with me.
Well, that's one way to get someone to say yes. You can't exactly.
I figured that, power of the people.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's great. He's just so talented. And we'll be doing some acoustic shows as well as bringing bands in where we can, and also playing some big festivals this year.
Ah, good. How
exciting. Groundwater, can't wait. Yes. And a bit later as well, the Gimpy Master.
Ooh, exclusive first lineup announcement here at Live on the Lot.
Yes.
How exciting.
I think I'm allowed to say.
Sure. Why not? That's going to be awesome. So you'll be playing all the new songs.
Yeah,
of
I can't wait.
Frozen Rabbit, which will be very exciting. So what do you do? I mean, you've got so many things going on, from being on the stage, being in front of the mic with ABC Saturday Night Country hosting that, also on screen Sydney Weekender. Yep. You've been doing that for quite a while.
Yeah, 14 years now.
Wow. That's awesome.
Where did that go? And I mean, that's just a fun show I get to be involved with, and more often when I can, because there's so much going on.
That's what I was going to say. With everything going on, what do you actually enjoy doing outside of, you know, performing arts and being on screen and on the microphone? Yeah. Is there anything that you like?
Yeah, I love
it. I feel like your style is something you're very good at as well. Do you like to put together your own style?
No, I just like, I'm
really?
Just, yeah, piecemeally, that bit of that. No, and I love to go to the markets. Mm-hmm. I love taking the kids out, going bike riding and hanging out with the kids and kicking the soccer, the footy around the backyard and banging a tennis ball against the wall, all that sort of stuff that, you know, we did, you know, at home.
Yes.
So
it's handball. Do you guys do handball?
Handball, oh, yes.
I feel like it's a dying sport.
I know. Oh, no, I mean, it's very, very cool in primary schools at the moment.
Oh, it is? Yes. Okay, cool.
Handball is back.
Good. I remember the handball days.
Want a little challenge in the corridor?
Sure, let's do that. We'll take it outside. Well, I'll let you go. You're so busy. Thank you so much for coming in again on your own this time. Brand new album, Frozen Rabbit, coming out.